want some feisty cherry.
He's exactly what you
need. I proposed to him. Here's what I proposed to Coca-Cola today. That they do cannabis Coca-Cola flavors.
I don't know that.
I'm going to get up soon.
Awesome.
All right. We're headed up to catch a bus anyway, so I'm going to be rolling here in a minute.
Thank you so much, Kurt.
I had to stop and say hi. He's an old friend.
I really appreciate it. You have no idea.
And I promised to call someone back that I haven't called yet. So I have to do that. Why I can still do it. Because they're on the East Coast. You can say hello, though. It's my cousin.
No, but realistically, my tissues, I mean, like, I don't know, like...
Hi, I'm with Emily, and she's a little nuts right now because she's going through a bad midlife crisis. I'd like you to say hello to her, and I told you you're in the medical profession, and you're my cousin, and then I need to talk to you for a few minutes before I continue to deal with her drama. But this is Emily. We've known each other since she was 17 and wanted me to have sex with her when she was a Vogue model, but she doesn't really remember that. And she's been a porn star and a celebrity and stuff. And this is my cousin Susan in Michigan. Say hello to Susan.
Hello.
Hi, Susan.
She's on
speakerphone. I go by Insight, actually.
How are you feeling today?
I go by Insight, my spiritual name, actually.
But do you have a website she can find you?
Yeah.
What name should she Google you under? Can she Google you?
No, actually, I don't have any public profiles. I was trying to remain anonymous.
There's no stuff on when you were in Vogue? There's nothing
incognito. Incognito.
What Vogue years were you in Vogue? What year were you in Vogue? She could look at Vogue magazine.
Oh, I think it was like 84 when I was 17 I was in Vogue. And then
when she wanted me to have sex with her.
I liked it.
And I had to say no. She was 17. She cried. She wanted to give me a blowjob. And I said
and
no.
And then you know what I did? When I was 20.
See, I have morals, Susan. I don't fuck everything that walks.
When I was 20, I walked away from my career and I went to go meditate in a shrine and I went to university and stuff. I moved to Colorado, basically country. I was living in New York.
Get her opinion about your masseuse guy, a woman's opinion who's in the medical profession. How would she deal with it if a guy kicked you out of class because of your disease? What disease do you have?
Tardive dyskinesia.
Ask her if she knows what that is.
Well, no, also, what
you know what her disease is? Tardive dyskinesia?
Do you know what the rising is, though?
No. Does she know what it is?
Okay, well, I had an enlightenment. And partly is because of the yoga. And
she's a medical professional. She needs
but
to
my
know.
Teacher, doesn't understand it. And you kind of neurologically shake and stuff. And he fucking,
kinda
after
like Parkinson's
10 years of practicing with him, he asked me not to come back because he
thought
didn't know
dangerous.
What was going on with me. And
you were upstaging.
What I think I was telling Kurt, I think what it really is about is,
you're
I mean,
female.
I really, I'm like full of light. And
he's full of shit.
Yeah, and he, and like, become very magnetic and powerful. And I think he's intimidated.
And you're much taller and bigger.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
How tall are you?
That usually happens. Because she was my teacher.
How tall
right?
are you? 6'4"? How tall are you?
No, almost 6'1".
All right. So tell her, you're 6'4". You're a tall model.
Yeah.
She's 6'4", Susan, and he's what, 5'10"? So you tower above him.
Yeah.
He's got the little man dick syndrome.
And also, like, sometimes teachers do that. When they have the leadership role and then, their students
tell
surpass them.
Tell me to sue them for HIPAA violation.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true.
Can she ask, can you sue for HIPAA violation? He discriminated against you. He discriminated. Hey, Susan, can she sue under HIPAA because he violated and discriminated against her in a class because of a medical ailment that she can't control and kicked her out? Is that against the law?
Probably.
There
you
go.
My mom said I should sue him for discrimination.
Millions.
I mean, I was really hurt. I had the guy on a pedestal.
He took your money for 10 years and kicked
you. And
I
just told him 2 weeks ago that I've been in the hospital 20 times this year. And I just told him that his dedication to God and his studio and all the work I've done with him has kept me alive.
Here, try some.
Literally.
Try some of these.
Kept me alive. And then he did that to me this week. Can you believe that?
What would Susan do? Susan, what would you do?
I would
Would you also get an attorney and sue the fuck out of him because you're a woman and he shouldn't treat you that way?
Oh, yeah, that's true.
See? There you go. That's a woman's opinion. She's in Michigan. And they're conservative in Michigan.
I'm just a really sweet person.
How old are you, Susan?
I realize
Sue, how old are you? Susan, how old are you?
What?
57. Okay,
and how old are you?
See,
she's 10 years older. And she would sue as a 10-year-old woman? Fuck yeah.
I had 3 relationships long-term.
You're also older, so you could sue as age discrimination.
And all 3 of them, there was domestic violence. Wow. And I walked away from property and, you know, my life, my friends, family.
Your agents.
You know, everything. To get away from these people. And
then she ended up with the Persian Mafia.
And then I've been with this guy for 15 years, and I just got my own apartment.
She's only had sex 10 times in 15 years.
I decided.
Susan, could you only have sex 10 times in 15 years with your husband?
Yeah, I compromised a lot. Compromised a lot with him. But anyways, I did not want to take his apartment. I mean, definitely could have had his apartment.
He also freaked out because she was a professional escort and a stripper in porn films.
Oh, yeah. And plus, I was Grace Jones' lover.
Tell her. You've been in porn films.
And he didn't like that. So, like, he wouldn't let me talk about my past. I'm bisexual. He wouldn't let me talk about it. He'd tell me, you know, that's gross. And anyway, so I decided, because I'm on...
So much for the right to choose as an adult woman how you want your body to be used.
Because I'm on Section 8 and SSI. I'm very low income. I've decided that I think I should get some money because, like, I helped him develop his company. I went to all of his business meetings. I created an image for him. I fucking wardrobed him. I, you know, edited all his emails because he's Persian. He doesn't speak English very well. You know what I mean? I mean, like, I was his companion. And, you know, and he makes good money. He's a lot. He designs, like, houses for celebrities and shit. And he didn't give me a dime.
Hey, Susan, if you two want to trade numbers, that's up to you girls if you want to trade numbers.
He didn't give me a dime. Here, I don't smoke. I told you I don't smoke or drink after somebody else.
I lit it for you because you couldn't get a lit.
That's sweet, but I just don't.
Okay, that's fine.
I just don't share my mouth with other people.
Well, if you're having sex with me, you're going to share your mouth, baby. You're going to kiss me all over.
No, when I was an escort, I did not do that.
I didn't say be an escort. I said, what? You have your lighter.
I want to work at a sex club. I did that before. You know, I set the boundaries.
This is a torch. You have the lighter. You know? I gave it back to you.
You know, it's kind of cool because... Like, when I worked in a sex club, I had more power than I did when I was in my own family because I was abused, you know? So I learned about my own power and my own boundaries, actually, as a sex worker. Isn't that cool?
I don't have it.
I think it's cool, too.
Oh, yes, I did. No, this is a different one. I gave it back to you. It's in your bag. I don't have it.
No, you took it again.
Okay. Here, borrow this one in the meantime until we find where
anyways.
Oh, here it is. Here, take that one. That's the new
you
one.
Sound really nice. I like you.
You can trade numbers if you want.
And let's trade numbers. Would you like that?
Sure.
I'm an interesting person. I'm really spiritual and...
Your new female friend in Hollywood. Yeah. If you can't stay with me,
Susan, with her.
Here's
my situation. I'm like, I won't bother you or anything, but... It'd be nice to be able to talk to somebody. I've been very focused on my guy, and I'm transitioning. I just got my own apartment for the first time in my life, and yeah, and I'm a very serious spiritual person.
Tell her what you want to do.
I do yoga and,
what
you know.
What do you want to do? She wants to produce sex films. You want to be in her sex film?
No, I would like
therapist?
To. I would like to be, I like to produce something that is meaningful in nonverbal communication and my, you know what I mean?
Erotic.
Like a tantric thing, but also that involves communication.
Susan, would you and Phil watch those kind of movies?
He's just he's highlighting that because he wants to have sex and all that stuff.
So do you. She told me she had orgasms 20,000 times in one time and her pussy turned around 10 times. Is that even possible, Susan?
Yeah, my clit. Yeah, and also, yeah, because... No, yeah, because what happened was...
That sucks. Guys don't have 20,000 orgasms.
I was on Wellbutrin, you know, and I had, like, my clitoris started spinning after a while. And also, I had a cunnilingus erection.
Susan, has your clitoris ever spun?
So what do you do, Susan? What do you do, Susan?
I just work in the hospital.
In an emergency room.
Oh.
She sees people
how
over.
How do you know Kurt?
My cousin. First cousin.
My cousin.
First cousin. Mm. We were playing doctor at age 5 and kissing cousins, and we were naked together, and she was supposed to marry me, and then she lost track of me at age 23.
Kurt's pretty wild, isn't he?
But he's real, and he's honest. Is that true, Susan? Everything I've told you has come true, including NSA fucking with your phones and computers today. Was that not correct? I predicted it before it happened that they wanted your location, and then they asked for it, didn't they?
Really?
Yeah.
I thought maybe he was paranoid or something.
Nope. Susan, how paranoid is your cousin, Kurt Joseph Edward Cronin?
Can I have a different lighter? This isn't working.
Here, hang on a sec. Susan, tell her how paranoid you think Kurt Kelly Joseph Cronin is, or is he really for real?
For real, not
paranoid at all.
Yeah, I didn't know because you know, the things he was talking about, and I met him at a mental health facility. You never know, you know.
Yeah, you never know.
But I liked him.
Well, when you're undercover, you have to play nuts sometimes.
But I liked his energy, and he did talk about some philosophical things, and he's intriguing.
I'm intriguing.
That's true.
And he's very unique.
Outrageous.
And very magnetic.
Gregarious.
So, you know, we've been hanging out a bit.
And we've never had sex, even though she's 47 and she wanted to give me a blowjob 30 years ago. How's that for restraint, Susan? 30 years, I've never tried to tap this girl. I've asked, but I've never forced myself. Have I? Have I even rubbed against your boobies?
Oh, yeah, he just wanted to give me a massage on the beach.
And she wouldn't let me do it. She thought I wanted sex.
No, I mean, I was with that guy. I mean, I was been with him for 15 years, you know? I'm a Leo. I'm a very serious
You know
serious
who you're
person.
Most compatible with? Geminis, and I'm a triple Gemini. You're most compatible with Geminis.
No, don't.
I'm trying to wake you
with
up.
My third eye. I'm fucking enlightened, dude.
Oh,
you don't
so
have
am
to
I. I know how to time travel, bitch.
I honestly don't even think I'm gonna live long because my whole body's
you will.
All light.
I'm gonna make you live long.
No, my body's all
you,
light,
if
man.
If you just let me work with you, you'd live a long time.
I've been in the hospital like 3 times this week.
Then let me heal you.
No, because I spin. You. My whole nervous system spins.
Because you're
and you know, and you know, body can't handle that. You know what I mean? So I literally see bright light.
And she also said her pussy was starting to spin while she was sitting next to me. How outrageous is that? I'm making her pussy spin and I haven't touched her.
I think it's because I did a lot of chanting and a lot of spiritual stuff.
She manifested me
and then
her pussy.
I stopped taking a mood stabilizer and an antipsychotic. And I did a bunch of yoga, and then they put me on 2 antidepressants. And
what were they?
The antipsychotic makes your body not move. It affects your movement, and it also messes with your intuition. And that's my spiritual name is Auspicious Insight. So I've got a spiritual gift of insight, and it was messing with that. So I wound up stopped taking it because they told me I had tardive dyskinesia, which is like a hell condition. But anyways, and then I had 3 psychiatrists tell me I'm not psychotic anyways. You know, because my psychiatrist doesn't understand spiritual things at all. You know what I mean?
Smell that oil.
You know, he doesn't believe in
smell
God.
The oil. Smell the oil.
When I found that out, I realized, dude, you are not just somebody who can judge me because...
Would you smell the oil, please?
Because I'm a very spiritual
please
person.
Smell it. Smell.
I don't like it.
Smell it.
I don't like it at all.
You didn't like the smell?
No. It's synthetic. I only
no, it's
like
not.
Aromatherapy.
It's natural oil.
I only natural like aromatherapy. Oil. That is not aromatherapy.
Okay, whatever.
They might have sold you on that idea, but it's not. It's
synthetic.
I didn't
say it was aromatherapy. I said
it's
it was scented
fragrance.
Oil. Scented oil.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I don't do fragrance.
Natural scented oil.
Anyways.
She doesn't like perfume.
But you don't have to give me, I mean, you don't have, you probably have a full life and friends and all of that shit. I just don't. So I thought it'd be nice to have somebody you know, once in a while to touch base with. That's all. Okay, cool. Thank you.
Give her your number.
Consider it a compassionate gift, because I have like maybe two friends. And one's married and one's 75, and she doesn't really do much and or talk much, and you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
So.
You know who you should introduce her to? Linda.
Linda. Oh, that Linda.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why?
My friend Linda.
Why?
Oh, she's a nice girl.
How many times has Linda been married? Nice. Ask how many times has Linda been married.
How many times have you been married, Susan?
Me, once.
How many times has Linda been married?
Twice.
And tell her about the last one. I met her just before she got married.
She's not married right now.
Oh, she divorced the rich guy?
Hey, you know...
She's never married to the farmer.
Who did she marry for the second marriage?
That's the one that passed away.
Hey, wait, Susan, you know what else?
Yeah?
You sound like a very open-minded person and non-judgmental. And, like, right now, my mom, like, she's here, you know, and she, I asked her for some emotional support, and she's just been nothing but critical, and,
how
you know,
she?
I don't know, anyway, she's very
mom?
Conservative, she got mad at me for dancing in the Goodwill, and gave me the evil eye and stuff, you know what I mean, like trying to control me, and,
Kind of the mom thing,
yeah, but also, I don't mind that she has different philosophical beliefs.
How old is mom?
From the 50s, I'm from the 60s. You know, I don't mind all that. But don't fucking try to interpret my reality.
Her mom's 87.
You know what I mean? Keep it to yourself. Don't try to, like act like you have the answer to my life or my destiny. You know what I mean?
Don't.
And act like you're an authority. And I've been begging her to get counseling for so many years because she gets angry and she's very controlling. But I love her to death. So we might live together, but I don't think so, because I have done 15 years of counseling. No, 30 or 40 years of counseling.
You're talking my cousin.
I'm moving and transitioning from being codependent.
I'm lighting my shit on fire. Can I have a cigarette?
And right now, what I need the most is encouragement and support.
He'd like a cigarette.
About my strengths, not about my, you know, picking on me. You know what I mean? So she's like, oh, you're going to get evicted. You know, you're not doing this right. You're not doing that right. Like, dude, I asked for emotional support.
You should put some stuff in it.
Yeah, come on.
Okay.
Yeah. And like, I'm done with like the counseling on trauma issues. Like, I'm gonna go to a spiritual counselor at Agape. You know Agape?
Oh, I don't do tobacco and weed together ever.
Anyways, it's a spiritual center.
It doesn't matter. I don't mix it too well.
And they do affirmative prayer. And you know, it's all about empowerment. Now I'm over, you know, being a victim. And talking about boys, and you know what I mean?
Ooh, you're just in a good body.
I'm into my own life, and yeah, and it would be nice to talk to another person that is a woman, similar age, and professional. And you know what I mean? That's the other thing. I don't meet people because I don't work, so it's really hard for me to meet people. And usually people I meet are like at mental health support groups or whatever. And I'm kind of high functioning, you know, like I'm, you know, like to read, I like to do yoga, I research things, I'm interested in things and I pursue them.
But then she's telling me
I just don't work, you know what I mean? But I've been to graduate school. And I'm very intelligent. And I just find that the people that I'm meeting, except for Kurt, but the people that I'm meeting, they're just not motivated and, you know, they're just not interested and they just don't take the time and they don't do the work. You know what I mean? They're not serious. And I am. You know? So.
And my cousin said, you know,
so it's hard to meet people for me. So.
And she said, okay, thanks.
That's all. So, do you have a pen?
Look at the girl up there, the black girl. Yeah, I just said.
Okay, I'll give you my number.
Fuck. Yeah. Do that one more time, I dare you. Do it again. Do it again. One more. One more time. Go tell him one more time. Tell him I'm videotaping. One more time. Come on, do it again. I'm videotaping.
And my name is
One more time.
It looks like a milkshake.
One more time.
It looks like a tug of milkshake. Let me see.
Come over here and do that.
Go give him over here. That's my dream.
Give him something.
To be a singer and performer.
Did you get alcohol? You went to get alcohol. Did you get it?
No, I didn't know if I'll live long enough.
Are you having fun? Oh, God. This is Nick. Nick, smile. You're on Ken's phone.
Oh, is that like a show? I'd love to. I would love to do that. Thank you.
Is that being my honor?
I'm gonna write it in my special.
How many people want me dead this week? I'm lost count. You know? The CIA, the FBI.
I mean, I did.
Yeah, that's what I heard too. And they're showing pictures around. And according to Trouble, took the best color photos they've ever seen of me. They're really current too. Probably when they booked me in Santa Monica or LA.
On $150,000
of awards.
I'm ready to go back.
No, I had $150,000. Listen, I have $150,000 of awards. All for misdemeanors.
I
have two misdemeanors.
I'd like to share my energy.
They're supposed to arrest you at $25,000. So they arrested me and then let me
out. I do a lot of writing. My energy is high.
And you know my answer? It's a state beach. Go fuck yourself.
I did a lot of real world stuff. You know, I would like, and then I was also in a lot of cancer.
By the way, the city does not own this fucking beach. It's a state beach, and your state laws apply over city laws, and I can't
even when I was a kid.
So go fuck yourself.
I did performances.
It's a public beach, and I pay taxes
in
Santa Monica too. I don't have to have a house here. I pay taxes
every time I buy shit.
So.
Yes, and naked people running in my dreams.
Oh, great.
I gotta go piss. I'll go somewhere safe. I'll be right back. Take care of her and my shit this year.
I knew that was my destiny. It was like interpreted.
I'll be back, Susan. I have to go piss.
But then I forgot about it. But now is the time. You know what I mean? Because I don't know how long I'm going to live. So let me write this down, the voice.
You're having a nice one.
Dark orange light.
I hope it's soon, because I don't know.
Orange light 3D to match his beard. He's the orange beard. I have my Michael Jackson gloves. All right, I'll be back. I left you my matches. She has gold balls in her ass. What?
And
what are your gold balls in her ass for? Holy Benoit. That's more information than I need to know.
I mean,
has balls in her ass?
I have a lot of nerve
damn, no wonder it's like spinning.
So, I don't know. I don't know if
damn.
I just
save me, Lord.
I'm an energetic body
I'll
now.
Be back after I relieve myself. I now have blue balls.
My body's listening to this. It's not the same. I'm not normal. At all. That's
my mess around hat. Oh, I got my mess around glasses.
Yeah, thank you. That's what I was trying to tell my mom.
You need to zip this up.
I was like, Mom, I'm not normal, but that's okay. You know? Support me.
You want me to hang on to her so you don't lose her? You got it. I'm coming right back. I have to go to the bathroom. Put her number in your phone.
Okay, honey. Thanks for talking to me. Are you a nurse?
No.
What are you doing in a hospital?
I move people around, like...
Well, God bless you, and thanks for the support, and I wish you the best, and I look forward to speaking to you one day.
Okay. Thanks, honey. You're welcome. Bye-bye.
I want more Coke. Where do you go? He did not give me a gram. Give me a break. Come on, you know Coke. That is not a gram. I was like a quarter. I'm gonna go after him. I'm gonna go after him, because I wanna go to Venice. I mean, that was a tease. You know what I mean? I don't like to be teased. He's so funny. He gets distracted and he goes and talks to people. But maybe he wants me to stay here and wants to shit, but he knows you, right? Right, man? Go, man. I told my mom I'd be 2 fucking hours. And he keeps on getting distracted. I can't keep up. I'm serious, man. I'm tired. I cannot keep up. I don't have my medicine. I didn't sleep last night. I'm just gonna blow it. I'll blow it off.
Oh, I thought you were still talking on the phone. I'm sorry.
No, I'm talking about Kurt. Yeah. Anyway, I'm fucking tired. And I usually do Adderall, man. And I do need like a gram to fucking even compare to what I do. With no sleep, and I did 90 minutes of yoga, you know, and then I walked a bunch. I'm not in the condition to do that. I don't do that kind of shit. I don't walk around. He doesn't get it. I mean, I don't mean to be pushy, but like, if we're gonna do blow, let's do blow. You know what I mean? Don't tease me. I think I'm gonna blow it up. I can't even get to Venice. I'm fucking getting tired. I don't even see him.
Well, if you want me to help you with the clitoris, you can always do that.
What?
I said if you want me to help you with that spinning clitoris, I can do that. Spinning this up too.
That's sweet, thank you. I said that's sweet, thank you.
You're doing the right thing, young man. You know what time it is.
I hope he comes back soon, man. Because I literally told my mom I'd be a couple hours. My mom worries, you know. She's with me right now. And I just got out of the fucking hospital, like, you know, 2 days ago. Because I've been really unstable. I'm worried, you know? And then he had to stop, talk to people over there. We literally have talked to 5 people. Fuck, man. And then walked like fucking all the way from a 7-Eleven here. I'm tired. So you've been trying to stay stationary?
Yeah.
Are you homeless? You're at home in the universe.
Yeah.
that.
Then I'll do. Right.
I'm sorry, I have a hard time hearing you because that fucking guy is yelling. Driving me crazy. What, honey? I can't hear you.
I don't know.
Kurt, can we blow it? Can we go?
Yeah, but you hung up my cousin. I asked her to call her back.
I know, but honey.
Well, honey, what? No, let me call my cousin.
Hey, sweetheart, you have a...
You have it all over your face.
I'm burning out, babe. I'm burning out.
That's not my fault. I still need to talk to my cousin. You spent an hour on the phone with her.
Can we do it on the way?
Can I make my call?
Can we do it on the way or on the...
Can I make my call? Yes or no?
I know, but can we do it on the way?
I don't want to answer that right now. Can I make my call? Yes or no? Can I have a few minutes with my family? I've been taking care of your needs. I need to take care of mine for a minute.
You have reached the voicemail box of...
Would you call me back as soon as possible on whatever night you need to reach me on? Emily took up time. I need to talk to you some stuff, and this is driving me clinically insane. Please call me right back.
Stay fly. That's my advice to everybody, boys and girls. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this next one I'm about to do. Ladies and gentlemen, you got your cameras out. You better keep them out. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the one where I get crazy and I'm rolling all on the ground. Ladies and gentlemen, I was 5 years old when this one came out. Ray Charles was rocking the country from Miami to Minnesota, from New York City to South Carolina, all the way from D.C. to Houston, Texas, 1965. What I say?
I need a moment of sanity for Kurt. So I'll take a moment away from Emily because I've had an Emily overdose.
Hey, mama, don't you treat me wrong. Call me love it, daddy, all night long. All right, now,
I can't let other people's toxicity run my life. Not when I'm working on me.
See the girl with the diamond ring? She knows how to shake that thing. All right.
You are beautiful.
Hey, hey.
Where are you from?
Germany.
Hey, hey. I have clients in Cologne and...
I live in Cologne.
Oh, then you may know some of my friends. They do the commercials for Bayer.
Bayer.
Bayer Corporation. I'm the voice for Bayer in English.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and for BMW and Lufthansa.
I'm
and
responsible for Bayer.
You're what?
I work for Orange.
Oh.
Do you have a power box up here?
A what?
Power?
Yeah.
Can I have a
minute? Oh, I do. You're so beautiful. I could have a lot. Yeah, you have Android?
I know.
Oh, do you have your plug? I have power, but I don't have a Mac.
No.
Is it Android or Mac?
iPhone.
I don't have iPhone yet. Oh, you know what? I have one over here. Come over here. I do have one. With myself right there with that girl. But I want to
see the girl with the red dress on. She can do the burlap all night long. Oh, yes, she can. What I say?
I pull out the...
I stay here.
No, I have a cable for your phone. Yeah. Over here. If you come over here, I'll let you use it. No, because I'm with her. I have to stay.
Okay.
Say, all right. I want to know right now. Say, I want to know. Say, I want to know right now. Say, I want to know. Say, I want to know, yeah.
Wait a minute, hold on. Hold on, no, no, we ain't going out like this, nigga. Hold on. Hold on now, hold on. Hold on, I want everybody to help me out. Everybody help me out. Hold on.
Okay, I'm ready to go. 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 I'm leaving if you're coming. I'm leaving now.
I think I lost you shortly.
Say it one more time. Say it one more time.
You can go over here and I'll hold it up.
Make it feel so good right now.
What's your name?
Sonia.
You work for Bayer?
No, I work for Oracle.
Oracle Technology?
Yes.
Oh, I've worked with Oracle.
Yeah.
What do you do?
I'm an IT architect.
We should talk.
I'm so very technical.
Do you know about 360 virtual reality?
We are not so into that in the moment.
I asked you to know about it. That's all I asked. Not if you're into it. I know you're not. I do technology also. I help invent a lot of technology use. I help invent audio video streaming on the internet, voiceover IP, and SSL technology for a credit card. Where did I put it? Somewhere buried in here. I hit it. I have cables.
I see it.
I have device issues. In the bag, it's in there. It's oh, I know where I put it.
I wanted to keep it separate because it's not a cable I use. Here it is. See if that one. Will that fit? Is that a Mac cable? It doesn't fit Android. Really?
Yep.
Or it's for a different one.
That's for maybe Connor or something.
Oh, this is Samsung. Why didn't you get my devices? It must be old. I don't have one. You don't have an adapter?
No. If I go to the Apple store, do you have a card?
Oh, on the I can give you my information. Plus one. Do you have US or German? Plus one, 424.
Wait, not so fast.
How long are you here for?
For work.
How long are you here for?
Till Sunday.
Oh, all right, next Saturday on the other side of the dock, are you listening? They're having the International Film Awards. Celebrities from Germany and around the world will be there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you should go. I can maybe get you in if you text me your information.
So, plus one?
Plus one, 424-310. Oh, shit. 310-9789 or 9719 or 9720. It's Kurt.
I have one.
Well, I have three numbers. If you
What's
don't reach
name?
Me on one, you can reach me on the other. 97, 18, 19, or 20. Kurt, K-U-R-C. Oh. Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y. I do television and film. If you Google me, you'll see I've done everything from...
Kurt Kelly?
Yes, films with Morgan Freeman. I'm in video games. I'm in television and film for nearly 50 years. How old are you?
39.
Can we get married now? I think you're gorgeous.
I am.
All right, can I be your second husband in America? All right, I'll be your lover. How's that? What time
My American
are you?
Lover didn't want me, so...
But I do. How old... what's your birthday?
January.
Oh, you're a Capricorn?
Yeah.
Or Aquarius?
Capricorn.
You people carry grudges. If you piss them off, they will remember it for life and make sure you never... Is that not true? You carry grudges? You're beautiful.
Thanks a lot.
What's your name?
Sonia.
Will you send me your stuff so I can reach out to you?
Yeah.
Are you on WhatsApp?
Yeah.
I'm on WhatsApp also with those numbers.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Much love. Much love. You're beautiful. God, you're hot. Huh? I love you. Goodbye.
My text is evening when the saints go marching in. Here comes Brother Higginbottom down the aisle with his trombone. Oh, yeah. 1939 when the saints go marching in. You better stop by Popeyes and get that $5 with a biscuit. We go down. When the saints go marching in, now when the saints get marching in, yes, I want to be in that number. When the saints get marching in, oh yeah, ladies and gentlemen, when them saints go marching in, I'm telling you right now, girl, you better have the breath in the right, already ready, cause I'm saying to the saints, I'm about to say, give me smoking weed all weekend, so you know they got the money. Oh yeah, look past. Oh yeah. Now when the saints are marching in, now when the saints are marching in, yes, I want to be in that number. When the saints are marching in, oh yeah, ladies and gentlemen, you know when the saints are marching in.
What?
gosh, you're beautiful. Where are you from? Okay, have a great life, you stuck-up individual. Wow.
It's about you. I don't need to be abused for being nice or shunned or walked away from because you think I'm a homeless person or some wild crackhead. Yeah, not interesting. Karma. Thanks for letting me know we're out of the box. It's a waste of time to even talk to you. Oh, thank you, God. And where was I? No, it's coming through slight. Emily has been pitching the yards on those games. She's listening to the beach. I was assaulted here 2 months ago, and no one seems to have found the people who did it. She isn't that fascinating.
Belly whites! That's what he's saying. Jagnut! Magnanite, how have you been?
I'm good, how are you?
I haven't seen you in a long time. I'm still alive. In spite of what they said, he's back. He's just been hanging in Venice where people don't fuck with him because Kurt said, I'm done with assholes. Get away. No one wants to fuck with me anymore.
That, man.
Nobody's fucking out with me anymore. Well, I'm just tired of being fucked with. I think it's open season on assholes.
That's nice, man.
Yeah, it gets your attention. A million votes won't kill you.
Yes, it will.
Yeah, it will. You don't want to fuck with me. I'm a nice guy.